Hello children, welcome back to our EVS class. So today we are going to discuss about another topic in this lesson, houses around us. So what do you see on the top of your house? Your house has got a particular part on the top, on its top, and that part is known as roof. So let us discuss about roof. So first of all, you take your textbook. There is a poem in the textbook with respect to roof of your house. So take page 210. Roof of a house. Let us read the riddle and identify the object. So a riddle is given. So I'll recite the riddle and you also recite along with me. Above your house, I will always stand like a crown, proud and grand. On you, sunlight, rain, and storm cannot fall. I am there for one and all. People make me in different shapes. Sloping, flat, and dome are some of my names. Can you guess who am I? So, in this riddle, it is mentioned about a particular part of the house, and that part is known as roof. The spelling of roof is R-O-O-F. So let us read the riddle once again. Above your house, I will always stand. So roof is above our house. And how does it look like? It looks like a crown. Who wears a crown? A king and a queen will wear a crown. All of you know what is crown, isn't it? So when wearing a crown, you feel proud and grand. And on you, so who is the you here? It is the roof. On the roof, sunlight, rain and storm cannot fall. So since the roof is there on the top of the house, it protects us from sunlight, rain and storm. I am there for one and all, and people make me in different shapes. So the roof is found in different shapes. So each and every house has got different shaped roofs. Sloping, flat and dome are some of my names. So the names of the roofs are sloping roof, flat roof and dome shaped roofs. So we are going to discuss about the different types of roof. So let us have a look on the slide. So children, can you see the spelling here? The title is R-O-O-F. How do you spell it? Roof. R-O-O-F. So here you can see the picture of the roof. So roof is found on the top of the house. So on the top of each and every house, we have a roof. What will happen if we don't have a roof? If you don't have a roof, when it is raining, rain will fall into the house. And the house as well as the people are not protected properly. So every house needs a roof. So what is roof? Roof is the important part of a house. I repeat, roof is the important part of a house. And it protects us from stray animals and weather. It protects us from stray animals. Stray animals means all the animals which are found on different roads, even wild animals. So we have stray dogs, stray cats, so many animals are there. So it protects us from stray animals and weather. It protects us from rain, storm, thunder, lightning, so many things. Now there are three types of roofs. There are three types of roofs. They are flat roofs, slanting or sloping roofs, and arched roofs. I repeat, three types of roofs. First one is flat roof. So the shape of flat roof will be just flat. We can see almost all the buildings here has got flat roofs. Now second one is slanting or sloping roofs. So from the name itself, we know that it has got a slanting position. In your KG classes, you might have learned about slanting line, sleeping line, etc. So what is a slanting line? It is not in a straight way. It has got the shape is different. Slanting and sloping. Then third one is arched roof. Arched roof has got a circular shape. It has got a circular shape. Now here, you can see three pictures here. The first picture shows a flat roof. This is a flat roof. So first picture shows a flat roof. The second one shows a slanting or sloping roof. See the shape here. It is not straight. It's not flat. It is in a slanting position. In Malayalam we say cherinjirikkuka. So this is the slanting roof. And the third one, here you can see a dome shaped roof, or we can say a round shaped or an arch shaped roof. So here you can see normally in front some churches as well as mosque, they have domes on the top of the building. So this is called a dome. This shape is known as dome. Now let us see what are the details. So houses constructed in plains and dry areas have flat roofs. So those houses which are constructed in plains and dry areas, that is the normal places, they have flat roofs. So maybe our houses will have flat roofs, but some houses will have slanting roofs. Depending on the type of construction, the type of the plan and all, the roof's shape may vary. But normally in Kerala we have flat roofs, this type of roofs. Now see the second point, houses in hilly or rainy areas have slanting or sloping roofs. So where do we find slanting or sloping roofs? Houses in hilly or rainy areas. In hilly or rainy areas, that is in hill stations and places where it rains mostly, that places they have slanting or sloping roofs. So what is the purpose of having this slanting or sloping roofs? These slanting or sloping roofs, they allow rainwater or snow to slide easily. So in hilly areas there might be snowfall, where the places are so cold there may be snowfall. So this snow will fall on the roofs and it can slide easily, it can slide easily to the ground. And in rainy areas, that is where there is too much of rains, this rainwater can slide easily through this slanting or sloping roofs. I repeat, slanting or sloping roofs. So rainwater and snow can slide easily through this type of roofs, which is the second type, slanting or sloping roofs. The first one is flat roofs. Now what about the third one? We can see the dome of the mosque here. This is a mosque and here this is the dome of a mosque, which is the worship place of Muslims, mosque. So normally mosques have a dome shaped roof there, a structure called dome here. So what is the shape? It is an arch shape or round shape. Houses in polar regions has a round or arch shape roof. I repeat, houses in polar regions. What do you mean by polar regions? Polar regions are places where there is too much of cold climate. So in such regions, people live in a particular house. What is that house called? I told in my last class, that is called igloo. So in that region, they have round or arched shape roof and it has the shape of a dome. So such type of roof has got a particular shape and that shape is known as dome. Spell the word dome, D-O-M-E. So it can save people from hurricanes and earthquakes. So dome shaped roof can save people from hurricanes and earthquakes. So it will save us from this chudalikata, and earthquake means bhoomi gulukam. In Malayalam we say bhoomi gulukam or bhugambam. So such type of roofs will save us from earthquakes and hurricanes. So the most safe type of roof is dome shaped roof, or we can say arched or round shaped roof. So it is well balanced and it can be maintained in a proper way. So we learned three types of roof. Which are they? They are flat roof, second one is slanting or sloping roof, and the third one is arched or round shaped roofs, that is also known as dome shaped roofs. Okay, so flat roofs are found in plains and dry areas, and in hilly stations and rainy places we have slanting or sloping roofs, and in polar regions or the places where there is cold climate we find dome shaped roofs. Okay, so let us move on to the next slide. Now, do you all keep your houses clean? Yes. So what are the different tips that help you to make your house clean? We need to keep our house and each rooms in our house neat and clean. So we have to clean our house every day. Now what about the vessels and utensils that we use? That also should be washed and kept in a proper place. And we should place all the waste materials in dustbins or waste bins. Now we can do proper gardening outside. We can water the plants, we can grow plants. So all these things we can do. So these are the different tips to maintain a clean home. So let us see the slide. Tips for keeping your home clean. So the first point is clean your house regularly. So every day we should clean our house. Second point is throw garbage in dustbin. So what is garbage? Garbage means all sorts of waste materials. So that garbage should be thrown in dustbin. Now the third point is wash the utensils after use to avoid flies and cockroaches. So after having food, we have to wash our utensils in order to avoid these flies and cockroaches. So what will happen if you don't wash your plates and all? Flies and all will come, and it will bring bad smell. So after using everything, we have to wash and keep it in the proper places. Now the fourth point is grow plants near your house. So we can grow plants near our house, in our garden, in our courtyard. All these things we can do. Now after growing plants, we have to water it. We have to give it proper sunlight and all. Okay. So these are the different tips for keeping a clean home. Now you can see certain new words which you have to write and study 5 times in your rough books. So all of you will have rough book, isn't it? So based on this lesson, some important words are written on the board. So I will spell the words. These words you have to write and study 5 times in your rough book, and you have to learn it by heart. The first one is pakka, P-U-C-C-A, pakka. Second one, kacha, K-U-T-C-H-A, kacha. Third, permanent, P-E-R-M-A-N-E-N-T, P-E-R-M-A-N-E-N-T, permanent. Fourth word, temporary, T-E-M-P-O-R-A-R-Y. Fifth one is hut, H-U-T, hut. Sixth one is apartment, A-P-A-R-T-M-E-N-T. Seventh one is tent, T-E-N-T. Eighth word is bungalow, B-U-N-G-A-L-O-W. Ninth word is houseboat, H-O-U-S-E-B-O-A-T, houseboat. Tenth one is caravan, C-A-R-A-V-A-N, caravan. 11th word is igloo, IGLOOS, igloos. 12th word is stilt house, STILT, stilt, HOUSE, house. 13th word is flat roof, FLATROOF, flat roof. ROOF is roof, FLAT is flat. So together we read it as flat roof. 14th word, slanting or sloping roof, SLANTING bar, SLOPING, sloping, slanting or sloping roof, ROOF. Next one is arched roof, ARCHED, ROOF, arched roof. Next one is dome, DOME, dome. So some words come from your last class and some words come from this class. Last class you did not have any words to write and study since you had exam. So all the words are included in this slide. Now these are the notes which you have to copy in your EVS notebook. So fill in the blanks. A tent is a dash house. Answer is temporary. Second one, dash are built in cold regions. Answer is igloos. A dash is a house on wheels. Answer is caravan. Fourth one, a houseboat is made of dash. Answer, wood. Fifth one, houses in plains have dash roofs. Answer, flat. Flat roofs. Next one is houses in hilly or rainy areas have dash roofs. Answer is slanting or sloping roofs. Next one, houses in polar regions have dash roof. Answer is arched or round. A dash shaped house can save people from earthquakes. Answer is dome, D-O-M-E. Next one, houseboats are found in Kashmir and dash. Answer is Kerala. Don't you find houseboats in Kerala? Yes. Now 10th one is bamboo poles are used for making dash houses. Answer is stilt houses. Next one, a tent is made of dash. Answer, canvas. Dash is an example for kacha house. Answer is hut. Dash and dash are examples for pakka houses. Which is the answer? Bungalow and apartment. Next one is name two materials used for making pakka houses. Answer, bricks, cement, etc. There are two others in the textbook, iron and steel. So you study two words, bricks and cement, two materials. Next one, name two examples for temporary house. Answer is tent, caravan. So these are some fill in the blanks questions and two, name the following. So you can study these answers. So for the exams, questions like this can be asked, okay. Now next is the answer the following, the questions which are given at the back of your textbook. So three questions are there. That three questions you need to copy down in your notebooks and you have to write and study these answers. Okay. So what type of a house do you live in? Answer is, normally we all live in pakka house. So you have to write, I live in a pakka house. Second one, write any two materials that are used for making a kacha house. Answer, wood and straw are used for making kacha houses. Third one, Mohan stays in a place where it rains very often. The roof of his house is flat. What type of roof should he have? Why? Answer, he should have a slanting or sloping roof because it allows water to flow down easily. So these are the question answers which you have to copy down in your notebook. And the exercises which I gave before in this slide, you can study. It's good to copy down in your notebook. If you find it difficult, you can study it from the slide itself. But the question answers you need to write in the notebook. Okay. So that's all for today's class. We discussed about roof, which is an important part of the house. The function of roof, it protects us from stray animals and weather. We learned about three types of roof. Which were they? They are flat roof, slanting or sloping roof, and the third one is arched or round shaped roofs. So read the textual part thoroughly 5 times and copy down the question answers as well as the fill in the blanks and name the following, and you have to learn it. So that's all for today's class. See you again in the next class with another chapter. So bye bye.